You said, I guess you know I love you.
I know. But I don't want to take, I don't want to put you in that spot. But
no, I'm standing in that spot. I love this guy right here. Let me give this guy a hug right here.
I love this guy right here.
That's really nice. And that's from the heart. I didn't want to put you in that position, you know, but that's from the heart. Special guy.
Howdy, y'all. Welcome back to the Wright Brothers. We appreciate y'all taking this time once again to come back and join us. If this is your first time watching, please feel free to leave us a comment. Let us know what you think afterwards, after you're done watching the video. All we always say in this channel is, the only way we're going to make free thought great again is by being willing to have the conversation, and all we ask is that you contribute to that conversation. Now, without further ado, today's topic is the world of entertainment and how it relates to politics. We've seen some honestly crazy, wild things happen in the world of politics and how it relates to entertainers and the entertainment industry as a whole. And we'd be remiss if we did not break into those. So these are truly Scheherazadean times that we live in. We see things happen every day, seemingly, that you would not even believe could ever happen if you were to think they would happen 5-10 years in the past. But here we are, 2018, and it's time for us to talk about these important issues as they develop. So the first thing we want to talk about is the fact, obviously, we heard about Taylor Swift coming out and saying that she was not a fan of President Trump. And that's okay. That's fine. We believe in open dialogue here in this channel, and we believe that you're doing yourself a disservice if you choose not to air your grievances in the political forum. What we saw on the other end, though, is we saw Kanye West and Jim Brown actually with the opportunity to go to the White House to meet with President Trump. And what came out of that really was two different opinions by the general public on these two very public outcries from these two celebrities. And for more on that, I'm going to turn the floor over to Eddie now.
Well, yeah, and I'd like to preface any comments that we make about this and other situations that come up is that my personal druthers when it comes to celebrities is I don't really care to have them enter the political fray at all. That's not to say that I don't think that they have the right or feel like they should shirk their duty if they feel that they're so led to jump into the political fray. But just from a purely, you know, business or entertainment standpoint, entertainers, their appeal comes from being able to kind of galvanize people on both sides of the aisle to appreciate their talent, be that music or sports or film, whatever, what have you. So I always see it as a little bit of a, you know, maybe a business misstep to cater to one side of the aisle or to another on any political topic, unless it's something, you know, so broad that, you know, just about 95% of people can agree on it. So that's always my caveat when I start, you know, talking about celebrity takes on politics one way or the other. But when it comes to the meeting that Kanye West had with President Trump, it's really interesting to note that for me personally, it's less about what Kanye actually said, more about the reaction to it. Because let's face it, celebrities weighing into the political battlefield is nothing really new at this point. We've seen a ton of it, especially since the 2016 election. But what's interesting about the Kanye West and Donald Trump saga is the type of blowback that's coming back from it. Because let's be honest. Kanye West, he is not a conservative. Let's get that out of the way right now. He can wear the MAGA hat all day long, but he has literally said straight up, he is not a conservative. He actually likes Hillary Clinton. So I like to caution people on the right from, you know, advocating for him to speak at CPAC or something in the future, because let's face it, he likes Donald Trump and he's not afraid to say it and not afraid to work with him. That's brought a lot of scrutiny his way, but he is not. He's not identified as being on the right side of the aisle. Actually, his whole bit about, you know, wanting to be a free thinker, that's actually a very liberal mindset, and it's one that frankly we don't have a problem with on this channel. But it's very important to realize where people are coming from. But beyond that, obviously he's not a political mind. Where this is Kanye West we're talking about here, a savant when it comes to the rap and music industry, and a mogul when it comes to building wealth, and obviously married into a family that's adroit at doing that as well. But Thomas Sowell, Kanye West is not. And that's not a knock on him necessarily, but it's just you have to understand who you're dealing with here. So when I hear attacks come at him from the left, and they're coming from a purely almost universally racist standpoint, calling him token Negro, saying that him being at the White House is a minstrel show, so on and so forth. That really gives me pause, because if you want to tear apart his arguments or tear apart like his manner of speech, it's pretty easy to do so. But the fact that it's coming from a cultural Marxist standpoint almost universally is what makes it really a really interesting story to follow. And it's actually kind of shining a magnification on the type of treatment that minority conservatives and minorities who are just not leftists necessarily have been, you know, treated to over the years. Damani, I know you have some thoughts on that as well. I waxed a little bit long, but that's kind of where I'm coming from with the whole Kanye situation in general.
Right. Well, Kanye West, it's no secret that he is the king of idiosyncrasy. Mm-hmm. And he is very eccentric. And that's not necessarily a bad thing. But what you see is, we talked in our very first episode back in June about identity politics. And what we see, though, is that we see these attacks being levied against Kanye West are being levied solely on the basis of who he is as a person, not based on what he says. And that's something that's honestly very telling, because typically when someone takes offense or takes umbrage with whatever you say, if you say that you are a conservative or you like President Donald Trump or whatever, they will not attack the substance of your argument, much as they will attack exactly who you are as a person. Mm-hmm. And I find that to be a huge problem with public discourse today. But we also see the dichotomy of the two different reactions as it relates to Kanye West professing his support for President Donald Trump. And then you see the examples of overflowing and effusive affirmation by celebrities who came out and endorsed Taylor Swift's remarks on Donald Trump. And let's go ahead and jump into some of those right now, and then we'll get back into it, and we'll bring this home for y'all.
Taylor Swift just posted an extremely political post on Instagram, and I'm so happy. She has held back from that kind of stuff for years, and I'm so glad she's using her huge platform for good and speaking out. I'm crying because Taylor Swift finally took a political stance. What is wrong with me? All jokes aside, what Taylor Swift just did is extremely important. Let's not forget, 53% of white women voted for Donald Trump. Having someone like Swift, who has a massive fan base, come out against a Trump-darling candidate like Marsha Blackburn is monumental in many ways.
A few moments later.
Trump appearing with Kanye West shows how desperate he is and how disturbed they both are. What hashtag Kanye West did in the Oval Office is an embarrassment. He's not outsmarting us. There's no game we just don't understand. He's just plain ignorant and high on his own fame that tells him it's cool to coddle up to a misogynistic racist like @RealDonaldTrump for headlines. Just when you think we can't sink any lower, Kanye West is in the Oval Office talking to reporters. By the way, Mr. Trump, there was a really bad hurricane.
So it doesn't take a rocket scientist to see that the type of feedback that people received, like Taylor Swift received, compared to the type of feedback Kanye West received, is completely different. And that honestly goes more to show how virtue signaling has really taken over our world from coast to coast, basically. So it doesn't matter what you say. We need to show our support for what we deem is the most socially appropriate thing to say or whatever. And you know what? We have the right to independent thought. Kanye West, as eccentric and wild as he may be, and as Eddie said before, he's not a conservative. He's just stating an alternate point of view. He has a right to espouse that viewpoint. And we see people coming out of the woodworks, you know, people threatening him with death or threatening him with physical harm or hoping that harm comes to him. It goes to show just how far we have fallen as a culture to where we refuse to accept and appreciate someone else's alternate point of view. Now, Eddie, I know that you've experienced some of this in your own day-to-day. We both talk about it in our Love Letters from the Left series, where we talk about the vitriol we receive from the other side. But what are some of the real symptoms that are deep at the heart of this issue, and how can we combat them moving forward? Because we cannot simply allow this type of treatment of others' points of view to continue, whether they be views that we agree with or views that we disagree with.
Well, yeah, and we've been saying this since the very first episode on this channel. The best way to combat this is honestly not to stoop to their level, and that's why personally, when I talk about celebrities when it comes to politics, I try to keep a very consistent viewpoint, because it's very easy to fall into the trap of, oh, well, you like this celebrity because they said what you like, and you dislike this one because they say what you don't like. Here's a rule of thumb. Appreciate celebrities for their talent, and I appreciate actors in a good movie or a good song, whether I agree with them politically or not. That doesn't affect my ability to enjoy their craft. For crying out loud, the head coach of my all-time favorite basketball team, the San Antonio Spurs. He does not like President Donald Trump one bit. That would be Greg Popovich. But that doesn't mean I'm going to like the Spurs any less, because that's not why he's on my radar to begin with. So as long as you're consistent in your view, and then when dealing with someone who maybe took umbrage with a viewpoint that you support, don't engage them on the level of cultural Marxism. Don't engage them on the level of identity politics. Try to push past that. And if they can't, some people aren't going to be willing to move past that, and that's their prerogative. You kind of have to let them be and move on. But if someone is willing to have that conversation with you and to kind of push past the whole you are X, so you must think Y, then I feel like that'll be a much more responsible way to continue the discourse, as opposed to trying to pin each other down on inane points that really have nothing to do with anything when it comes to politics, because politics is about ideas, not about immutable characteristics. So Damani, take us home on this one. I know we could go on all day, but it really is more about how you react to this type of blowback than the blowback itself, because based on your ethnicity or based on your gender or based on your sexual orientation, what have you, there's going to be somebody that has a problem with you. How have you dealt with that, and what's the best way to move forward in your estimation?
Yeah, I would say the best thing to do moving forward is don't be a leaf in the wind. Mm-hmm. Stand true to your convictions. So we've seen in the past couple of weeks is some people are coming out and they're giving Kanye these grandiose overtures of how much they love and respect him. Well, they couldn't tell you the lyric from any of his songs at all. You get people coming out and saying, oh, I can't stand this celebrity anymore, without having ever really been a consumer of that person's body of work. So stand true to your convictions. The main thing we could take away from this is that, you know what? As eccentric and wild and crazy as Kanye West is, he's supporting our president and he's stuck to his guns thus far. We don't know what he's going to do in the future, but we can all appreciate the fact that he has stuck true to his convictions and that he has not allowed himself to be played by the Democratic Party for the sole purpose of attracting minority votes to their party. I think there's something we can all learn from that. So, at the risk of being too loquacious, we appreciate y'all taking this time once again to come join us. Don't forget to check out our Facebook page, the Wright Brothers IPID, where you can engage with us on an even deeper level. We try to post regular content to the page about this cogent and salient topics of the day. And also, make sure if you haven't already, press the notification bell on YouTube so that you get our notifications when we do upload, because we want you to make sure that you are along with us every step of the way. As always, we could not do this without all of our wonderful supporters. A special shout out to Taylor Moore, to Monique Martinez, to our father, Dr. Eddie Lee Felder Jr., to our mother, Valerie Felder, to Almighty God, and to our loyal subscribers. We could not do this without you. We're going to have some exciting new developments coming up for you in the future. We're going to also jump back into Love Ledge from the Left soon. So look forward to that. And without further ado, thanks and gig 'em.
Hey, the power intro at Kyle Field, best entrance in college football. Thanks and gig 'em, Kanye.
The first revolution is when you change your mind about how you look at things and see that there might be another way to look at it that you have not been shown. The revolution will not be televised, and be no rerun, brothers and sisters. The revolution will be live.